Good afternoon and good morning. Welcome again to St. Francis of Assisi Parish here in Binghamton, New York. We welcome all those in our parishioners who are home viewing the liturgy and those in our surrounding area, wider community of Binghamton, and also all visitors and tuning in here from other areas. We welcome you. We are one in the body of Christ. I hope all of you, especially in our Binghamton area, are all shoveled out. After quite a snowstorm the other day. So as we continue in our preparation for Christmas, it does look a lot like Christmas outside with the snow. So as we gather then, let us be mindful on this fourth Sunday of Advent. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace, the peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with each of you.
And with your spirit.
We gather at God's house, reminded of the humility of the Lord. Long ago, he chose to pitch his tent with us, taking flesh in the womb of the Virgin Mary. Today, he seeks to make his dwelling in our community and find a home in our hearts. Let us make room for him. And this is what Advent is all about, making room for Christ in our lives, removing everything from our lives that is contrary to love, and prepare ourselves for the coming celebration of his birth on Christmas. And so at the beginning this liturgy, let us acknowledge our sins, but great gratitude, be mindful of God's enduring mercy in our lives. Lord Jesus, your kingdom, O Lord, shall endure forever. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, we have sinned against you. Yet you are faithful. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are our rock and our Savior. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Pour forth, we beseech you, O Lord, your grace into our hearts, that we, to whom the incarnation of Christ your Son was made known by the message of an angel, may by his passionate cross be brought to the glory of his resurrection. For this arranged with you in unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Welcome here to our liturgy today. Deacon Steve Playback and his wife Edie, who will be doing our readings, and Deacon Steve proclaiming the gospel and sharing in the homily.
A reading from the second book of Samuel. When King David was settled in his palace, and the Lord had given him rest from his enemies on every side, he said to Nathan the prophet, "Here I am living in a house of cedar, while the ark of God dwells in a tent." Nathan answered the king, "Go, do whatever you have in mind, for the Lord is with you." But that night, the Lord spoke to Nathan and said, "Go tell my servant David, 'Thus says the Lord, should you build me a house to dwell in? It was I who took you from the pasture and from the care of the flock, to be commander of my people Israel. I have been with you wherever you went, and I have destroyed all your enemies before you. And I will make you famous like the great ones of the earth. I will fix a place for my people Israel. I will plant them so that they may dwell in their place without further disturbance. Neither shall the wicked continue to afflict them as they did of old, since the time I first appointed judges over my people Israel. I will give you rest from all your enemies. The Lord also reveals to you that he will establish a house for you. And when your time comes and you rest with your ancestors, I will raise up your heir after you, sprung from your loins, and I will make his kingdom firm. I will be a father to him, and he shall be a son to me. Your house and your kingdom shall endure forever before me. Your throne shall stand firm forever." The word of the Lord.
Thanks
be to God.
Promises of the Lord I will sing forever. Through all generations my mouth shall proclaim your faithfulness. For you have said, "My kindness is established forever." In heaven you have confirmed your faithfulness. Forever I will sing the goodness of the Lord. I have made a covenant with my chosen one. I have sworn to David, my servant. Forever will I confirm your posterity and establish your throne for all generations. Forever I will sing the goodness of the Lord. He shall say of me, "You are my Father, my God, the Rock, my Savior." Forever will I maintain my kindness toward him, and my covenant with him stands firm. Forever I will sing the goodness of the Lord.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, to him who can strengthen you, according to my gospel and the proclamation of Jesus Christ, according to the revelation of the mystery kept secret for long ages, but now manifested through the prophetic writings and according to the command of the eternal God, made known to all nations to bring about the obedience of faith. To the only wise God, through Jesus Christ, be glory forever and ever. Amen. The word of the Lord.
Thanks
be to God.
The Lord is with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
The angel Gabriel was sent from God to a town of Galilee called Nazareth to a virgin betrothed to a man named Joseph of the house of David, and the virgin's name was Mary. And coming to her, he said, "Hail, full of grace, the Lord is with you." But she was greatly troubled at what he had said, and pondered what sort of greeting this might be. Then the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. Behold, you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you shall name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High, and the Lord God will give him the throne of David, his father, and he will rule over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end." But Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I have no relations with a man?" And the angel said to her in reply, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore the child to be born will be called Holy, the Son of God. And behold, Elizabeth, your relative, has also conceived a son in her old age. And this is the sixth month for her, who was called barren. For nothing will be impossible for God." Mary said, "Behold, I am the handmaid of the Lord. May it be done to me according to your word." Then the angel departed from her. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
If there is anything left of the first blue candle on your Advent wreath at home, today you will have all four candles burning, perhaps at dinner time, if this is when you usually light the wreath. I know that our first candle, and really the second as well, are pretty well burned down. We might just have to eat especially fast for the next few days to avoid setting the greenery that we picked from the woods behind our house on fire. That would be a bad Christmas omen. But today we are almost to Christmas. The celebration of Christ's birth is just around the corner. While Advent is 4 weeks long, it seems to go by in a flash. Today, our gospel passage from Luke has likely inspired more artists with more renditions of the Annunciation than any other subject in history. Mary was already betrothed to Joseph, which meant that they were married, but not living together yet, nor had they consummated their marriage. It's understandable that Mary was troubled by the angel Gabriel's message, particularly when he told her that the power of the Holy Spirit would overshadow her, and she would conceive a son who she would name Jesus. And this child would be called the Son of the Most High, meaning, of course, the Son of God. While she was a bit overwhelmed, she nonetheless told the angel that she would accept the will of God. There is no indication in the passage from Luke that after Gabriel left, Mary said, "Wait, I have so many more questions." She accepted God's will without knowing just how it would affect her life. How well do we accept the will of God? I hope this has been a good Advent for you. I hope you have grown closer to our Lord and appreciate even more just what it meant for God our Father to send his own Son to redeem us and save us from the ancient curse. I hope the readings of Advent have given you more trust and courage to deal with whatever you are dealing with on a personal level, and also what we are all dealing with on a worldwide level, namely the coronavirus and economic hardship for workers and business owners alike. As we have lit the Advent candles each week, I hope the increasing light has taken the chill away from you and given you hope. And what a nice surprise, we now have the beginnings of a vaccination campaign whose magnitude has probably never been witnessed. If we can just be patient a little longer and keep on being safe by masking and social distancing, perhaps we will, in a reasonable time, return to fuller churches and classrooms and life as it was before the pandemic. Most importantly, we must thank our God for sending his Son to us, our Lord Jesus Christ, and also for all the hardworking frontline people who have attended to us. We must also say a silent prayer for all who have perished and still might perish until this is over. If you can, spend a few minutes in quiet prayer this week before Christmas Day, praising and thanking our God for all he has done for us. Amen.
And proclaiming our faith, we'll pray the Apostles' Creed.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen.
On this fourth Sunday of Advent, as our season of waiting comes to an end, we prepare to welcome the Lord at Christmas, and we present our needs to our loving God.
Please respond, Emmanuel, God be with us. That even as we are distanced from one another in darkness, the Church may provide opportunities for all to live and grow in the light of faith, in welcoming our incarnate Savior into our communities, we pray to the Lord.
Emmanuel, God be with us.
That politicians and leaders of nations may be blessed with wisdom and concern for all humanity, ensuring that the COVID vaccines and appropriate medical care are made available to the most vulnerable, we pray to the Lord.
Emmanuel, God be with us.
That as we wait in expectation, seeing that a vaccine is near that will free us from the threat of COVID, may we also wait with joyful hope during these waning days of Advent, as Jesus draws near, knowing that he frees us from all darkness, sin, and tribulations. We pray to the Lord.
Emmanuel, God be with us.
That all pregnancies will be welcomed with love for the child to be born, with awe at the creation of new life, and with acceptance of a most holy role in God's creative plan, we pray to the Lord.
Emmanuel, God be with us.
that the children kidnapped in Nigeria may be kept safe from further harm, be freed from their captors, be reunited with their families, and find the support of local and global communities. We pray to the Lord.
Emmanuel, God be with us.
That during this year of St. Joseph, we may learn to be like him in accepting what life brings, welcoming others as they are, without exception, and to show special concern for the weak, for God chooses what is weak. We pray to the Lord.
Emmanuel, God be with us.
That those who are burdened with sickness, sorrow, and despair will be freed from their suffering and consoled by family, friends, and faith that Jesus comes to heal them. We pray to the Lord.
Emmanuel, God be with us.
That those whose time has come to rest with their ancestors will be at peace with the communion of saints in heaven. We pray to the Lord.
Emmanuel, God be with us.
And for our own intentions that we recall in silence. We pray to the Lord.
Emmanuel, God be with us.
God of all goodness, you provide the key that unlocks the way to salvation, the gift of your Son. Through him, you destroy the prison walls of death for all those who dwell in fear and darkness. As we await his return in glory, may we see in our world your desire to free all who are burdened with heavy chains. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness, we have this bread to offer. The truth is given, human hands have made. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
And blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, through your goodness, we have this wine to offer. Fruit of the vine, work and toil of our brothers and sisters' hands in the vineyards will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
My friends, pray that our sacrifice may become acceptable to God, our almighty Creator.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all God's holy church.
Amen. May the Holy Spirit, O Lord, sanctify these gifts laid upon your altar, just as you filled with his power the womb of the Blessed Virgin Mary, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord is with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For all the oracles of the prophets foretold him, the Virgin Mother longed for him with love beyond all telling. John the Baptist sang of his coming, and proclaimed his presence when he came. It is by his gift that already we rejoice at the mystery of his nativity, so that he may find us watchful in prayer and exultant in his praise. And so with the angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts, the powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts,
heaven
and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, our lives to these gifts by sending down your Spirit upon them, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." they said, away by supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which we pour out for you and for all, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you've held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly, we pray that partaking in the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, the Bishop of Rome, Douglas, our Bishop, and all the clergy and the religious. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection. And all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the apostles, the martyrs, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life. We may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. And through Christ, with Christ, in Christ, O God, Almighty Father, in unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
Like Mary in the scriptures today, may we welcome the kingdom of God into our lives and give birth to the God's kingdom in our words and actions as we pray, as Jesus taught us.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and graciously grant peace in our days. By the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope, the coming of our Savior, Jesus the Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins by the faith of your church, and graciously grant peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the non-violent Christ be with each of you.
And with your spirit.
If you're with family and your household, share a sign of peace. And if you're alone, let us just take a moment. Pray that we may be instruments of the Prince of Peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world.
Have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, take away the sins of the world.
Grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold, Emmanuel, God with us, takes away the sin of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
Act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you're already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Traditionally, on this fourth Sunday of Advent, we in the parish pray for expectant mothers and parents as they await the birth of their child, like Mary and Joseph. So offer this prayer for expectant mothers, if you are yourself pregnant or know a family member or friend, bring that name, bring their face to mind and hold them in this prayer. Let's pray this blessing. All-loving God, you created human family as a reflection of your own divine life so that your creation might share in your happiness. Hear our prayer for your daughters who await the birth of their child. She has cooperated with you in giving life, sister, now as she prepares to give birth to the child in her womb. May Mary be her guide and support, calming her fears and strengthening her love. May your daughters be filled with your peace and blessing so that she may bring forth her child into this world safely and in good health to the praise and glory of your name, now and forever.
Amen.
Let us pray. Having received this pledge of eternal redemption, we pray, Almighty God, that as the feast day of our salvation draws ever near, so we may press forward all the more eagerly to the worthy celebration of the mystery of your Son's Nativity, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Just a couple of announcements just to bring to your attention for your planning for this week, for Christmas. If you are planning to come to our liturgies, please call the parish center, our offices, during the week, Monday through Wednesday. I know, pretty sure now, that the 4 o'clock vigil Christmas Eve is full, and that the other masses at 10 o'clock on Christmas Eve and 8 and 11 on Christmas Day have room. So if you're interested in coming, those liturgies, please call or do it online to register for the liturgies. You have to do that in all the parishes in our area here in Binghamton. And also, after the new year, we are going to try a book club, and its details are in the bulletin for the upcoming book club on Tuesdays. You can do it, and if you're doing the Zoom, be on Zoom, and that will be taking place. What's the date?
January 5th.
So, and we're going to be doing the Pope's encyclical, recent encyclical this past fall, on Fratelli Tutti. It's not in Italian, will be in English. It's on social relationships. I'm almost finished with it. It's, you know, it really covers a lot, and I think it'd be a good discussion. If you're interested, let us know, and we could get the book that we'll be using for you to participate. And as Steve was mentioning about Advent, I always wondered why we celebrate Advent. It seems so much faster than Lent. But anyway, we hope that these remaining days for you are grace-filled as you prepare for Christmas and the celebration of the birth of Christ. And so I thank Deacon Steve and Edie for their ministry here today, as well as Sue and our videotaping. Let us keep one another in prayer. Now may God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Let us now go in the hope and the peace of the risen Christ.
Thanks be to God.
Have a good day and week ahead.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you.